Here he is, Mr. Ian Whitcomb and his bungalow boys.
Thank you very much, Mr. DeMille. And I hope you're enjoying this in Australia, in Melbourne. We have people in Melbourne listening, looking, watching, so behave yourselves. And here we have a song, a nice up-tempo number called 11:30 Saturday Night. All events of consequence in history are a mystery as to the time they happen. My event was heaven sent, and you can bet I'll not forget the time. For it was at the dance, I was in a trance, 11:30 Saturday night. In my arms I held a world of charms, 11:30 Saturday night. Saturday night. What went on in that room? Her husband came in unexpectedly. When I got there, I was so debonair. When he got through with me, I looked a sight. Oh, baby, 11:30 Saturday. Those were the days, but now they're simply in my memory because I'm a very happily married man. I'm sorry to say that my dear wife, Regina, who is normally here singing and dancing, is comatose. She's been asleep now for days. It's like she needs a charming prince to wake her up. But she will get better, I know. So let's do a nice waltz, shall we? Well, he wrote some good pop songs. Love's one of his.
No, it's
I recorded soprano. One of his from my time. Love something. All right, a waltz. This is, God, this is hard to put on.
I love this song.
Do you know this song?
Oh, yeah.
You know, this is a sad waltz. When the rest of the crowd go home, I always go home alone. Richard, give us a sad intro. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Just a little drink. We
to. Just a little drink. Well, we've all got drinks, but of course the bar is open and Max is always ready to serve you a special martini. We might even have the martini song later. Maxwell. What instrument? Okay. Let's just find one. Hang on. An instrument. Okay. Yeah.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to know if anyone
east
in the house
the
is celebrating a birthday tonight.
East of the sun.
Is it your birthday? Who's having a birthday? Anyone? Not you. You gentlemen, you sir, step right up to the dance floor. Don't be shy, because we're going to do a tradition here. Why, look, ladies and gentlemen, it's Max. Step up and say a few words. Now, ladies and gentlemen, here's a first. You can hear Max, the benignly belligerent bartender, actually speak.
I'm on my way to the bathroom.
I wish I hadn't asked. After all these years, the build-up, and that's what he says. Well, what's your name, sir? Lewis. It's Lewis's birthday. Is anyone else having a birthday? Well, here's a young lady having a birthday. And what's your name, miss? Vanessa and Lewis. Now, we need partners for these people. Someone to dance with Vanessa and someone to dance with Lewis. Here we are. Now, you can take turns, because the way this works is during the song, if anybody wishes to cut in, you may do so. And that's how a birthday dance works. Everybody takes turns dancing with the birthday people. And now, to play a delightful song for your birthday dance, here's Mr. Ian Whitcomb and his Bungalow Boys.
And the song is East of the Sun and West of the Moon. A one, a two, a one, two, three.
Thank you. It's a birthday.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for Mr. Ian Whitcomb to sing personally to Lewis and Vanessa, happy birthday. And let's all join in.
Happy birthday to you.
And Vanessa.
Happy birthday.
And a very happy birthday from the Cicada Club to you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, more music by Ian Whitcomb and his Bungalow Boys. And say, Mr. Whitcomb, what tunes will you be presenting for us now? What tunes will you be presenting
because
for
it's
us
a,
now?
We've had a birthday, and what do we have, a wedding or a marriage, or what was it?
I don't know what we have, but it's time to dance.
Well, we're going to have a song called Auntie Maggie's Remedy. It's a British song from George Formby that tells you exactly what to do if you get into trouble. Auntie Maggie.
Is this one of your cleaner songs?
Well, yes, it is. It's all in the mind, Maxwell. It's all in the mind.
That's what I was afraid of. Ladies and gentlemen, Ian Whitcomb and his Bungalow Boys.
All right, then we'll do your song. All right, here we go. This is a George Formby song from the north of England where they speak like that. Hey, Auntie Maggie's Remedy. Now there's all sorts of remedies that you can find, no matter what ailment you've got. I know a better one you ought to try. You'll find it's the best of the lot. It's me Auntie Maggie's homemade remedy. It's guaranteed never to fail. That's the stuff that will do the trick. It's sold at every chemist at one and a kick. If you've got lumbago, rheumatics or gout, or a pain in your rubber tea leaf, don't kick up a shindy, you'll never get windy with Auntie Maggie's remedy. Maggie's homemade remedy, it's guaranteed never to fail. That's the stuff that will do the trick. It's sold at every drugstore, one and a kick. Now I know a girl who is putting on weight in a place where it just shouldn't be. So I said to Nellie, you rub your kneecap with Auntie Maggie's remedy, and that'll fix it. Auntie Maggie's remedy. Hey, Auntie Maggie's remedy. Did you all enjoy the last chorus? I know a girl who is putting on weight in a place where it just shouldn't be. So I said to Nellie, you rub your kneecap with Auntie Maggie's remedy. So you see, that's a song from the 1940s when they didn't have modern medicine. And there were women who, well, anyway, we won't go into what they did. They did a lot with knitting needles. All right, so, now, Don.
Now.
Don's going to sing the devil. He's going to sing the next one. And now we're going to have Don Neely, who's coming to the microphone, to sing a great song by Harold Arlen. It's pretty classy for this band. We don't normally do as classy a song as this, The Devil in the Deep Blue Sea. But as it's come all the way from San Francisco, we'll let him do it.
Two. I want two.
but I hate to leave you. You've got me in between that old devil and the deep blue sea. I forgive you, but I can't forget you. You've got me in between the devil and the deep blue sea. I ought to cross you off my list, but you come knocking at my door. Fate seems to give my heart a twist, and I come running back for more. Now I should hate you, but I guess I love you. You've got me in between that old devil and the deep blue sea. You know I love you. Why? You've got me in between that old devil and the deep blue sea. Now I forgive you, honey, because I can't forget you. Because you've got me in between that old devil and the deep blue sea. Now I go cross you right off my list, but you come knocking on my back door. Fate gives my heart a twist. You come running back for more. Now I should hate you, but I guess I love you, 'cause you got me in between that old devil and the deep blue sea.
Say, folks, Mr. Don Neely. Now, Don, before you sit down, I'd like to ask you a question. Step right up on the platform, don't be shy. Where will you be performing with your orchestra next?
A private party, I guess.
For the public.
For the public. Which that's a long way off in, I believe, in May at the Art Deco Society, Art Deco Ball.
The Art Deco Ball. And which orchestra will be performing for that event?
The Royal Society Jazz Orchestra of San Francisco.
And, of course, you also play for that wonderful Gatsby Picnic, don't you?
That's correct. That's in September.
Well, maybe we could convince the folks here, we could bring you down from San Francisco and have you perform at the Cicada Club sometime.
Well, that would be swell.
As long as you work for free like Ian Whitcomb does.
Yes. That'd be great.
Thank you, Don Neely.
And now, Maxwell, will you put your magic crystal ball back into the future?
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do something very unusual here at the Cicada Club. Mr. Ian Whitcomb is going to peer into the future and see what type of music they will be playing many, many years from today.
And we're going to start off in 1955.
1955, well over 15 years in the future.
With a white sport coat and a pink carnation. White sport coat and a pink carnation. I'm all dressed up for the dance. A white sport coat and a pink carnation. I'm in a mood for romance. Once she told me long ago, to the prom with me you'd go. Now you change your mind, it seems. Someone else will halt my dreams. A white sport coat and a pink carnation, and in a blue, blue mood. She told me long ago, to the prom with me you'd go. Now you changed your mind, it seems. Someone else will halt my dreams. A white sport coat, happy carnation, and in a blue, blue moon. A white sport coat and a pink carnation. And now, let's bring onto the stage that cry man himself, Mr. Johnny Ray. Mr. Johnny Ray. With the earplug. The earplug. Okay. All right.
On the next set,
your sweetheart sends a letter of goodbye. It's no secret, you'll feel better if you cry. When waking from a bad dream, don't you sometimes think it's real, but it's only false emotion that you feel. If your heart aches, keep on hanging round too long, and your blues keep getting bluer with each song. Oh, now. Remember sunshine. Sunshine can be found behind a cloudy sky. So let your head out. Thank you. And go right on, baby, and cry. Okay, here we go. Go. It's only false emotion. Oh, that you feel. That you feel. Johnny Ray, who I once met in England. I met him backstage in England Very nice guy. He admired my belt. And so anyway, let's end this rock and roll session with a nice up-tempo number. Get out in that kitchen and rattle those pots and pans in the key of C, a shuffle rhythm in C. Okay, shuffling them off. Okay. Just shuffle into it. Watch, see, one, two, one, two, three. Get out in that kitchen, rattle those pots and pans. Get out in that kitchen, rattle those pots and pans. Roll my breakfast, cause I'm a hungry man. I said shake, rattle and roll. 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 Well, you never do nothing to save your doggone soul. I'm like a one-eyed cat peeping in a seafood store. I'm like a one-eyed cat peeping in a seafood store. I want your loving, but you won't give me no more. I said shake, rattle and roll. Shake, rattle and roll. Shake, rattle and roll. Shake, rattle and roll. Well, you never do nothing to save your doggone soul. Shake, rattle. Shouldn't we?
Is that the music they'll be playing in the future? My goodness, ladies and gentlemen, what a strange future is in store for all. You know, I heard another little tune from the future.
Yes, what's that?
Since you subjected me to that music, perhaps you could subject yourself to something that you made popular back in the future year of 1966.
You do this every time.
Not every time. I let you get off the hook last time. But since this is the last show of the year for you at the Cicada Club, perhaps, ladies and gentlemen, we could coax Mr. Whitcomb into performing his most famous hit from the year 1966.
65.
See, I wanted to make you a year younger, but 65 it is. What's the title of this tune, Mr. Whitcomb?
It was called You Turn Me On, or The Turn-On Song.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the final time this year, here it is, You Turn Me On, or The Turn-On Song. Watch out!
Here we go. You do. baby. Come on and do the jerk with me. And when you do, that's my song. Fred.
About. I have no idea what you're talking about, Mr. Whitcomb.
I have no idea either.
Is this about electrical switches and light bulbs and things like that? That must be what it is. I have no clue, but it's amusing. It's for the kids. The children enjoy that type of music.
It was inspired by Cole Porter.
Ah, Cole Porter.
When he was down on the docks.
I understand. Well, a Cicada Club exclusive, ladies and gentlemen. Nowhere else on the planet. Can you hear that song performed live except here tonight? And now, back to sanity, ladies and gentlemen, as we present music from the present time and none of that futuristic stuff. Say, Mr. Whitcomb, what do you have next in store?
Well, shall we do a Latin American number like Brazil, or is that too?
I think Brazil would be swell.
Spending.
What do you say, folks? A little Latin American number. Now, let's see some of you kids out on the dance floor and see if you can dance this tune. And we have over in the corner lurking, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. John Acreage, our former webcam director, our broadcast director.
It's a rumba, this, by the way.
This is a rumba. So put on your rumba shoes.
Thank you. sing one more.
Well, we've only got a few minutes left.
We're never going to be down here.
No. Well, we've only got another 10 minutes.
Huh?
And I put Fred. Promise Fred that as well. Fred. He's got a request for us in the name. What do you want to do?
You're driving me crazy.
Follow him, man. Stop him. So follow him.
Fred Sokol is going to do a lovely old number by Mr. Fat Swallow, as they call him in England. Fat Swallow ain't misbehaving. And Andy Razor.
Though it's a fickle age, with flirting all the rage, here is one bird with self-control, happy inside my cage. I know who I love best, thumbs down to all the rest. My love was given heart and soul, so it can stand the test. No one to walk with all by myself, no one to talk with, I'm happy on the show. Ain't misbehaving, I'm saving my love for you. I know for certain the one that I love, no need for flirting, it's you that I'm thinking of. Ain't misbehaving, I'm saving my love for you.
Fred Sokolo with Ain't Misbehaving. And now another guest who's come all the way down from San Francisco, as we've said before. So Don Neely will do a famous old Walter Donaldson song, You're Driving Me Crazy, Mr. Neely.
Thank you.
baby, drive me crazy. What did I do? Say, what did I do? What did I do? My tears for you make everything hazy. Out in the skies of blue. Now how true were the friends who were near me to cheer me, believe me they knew that you were the kind that would hurt me, desert me when I needed you. Oh, you dirty dog, drive me crazy. What did I do? What did I do? I don't know. What did I do? I don't know. Where's the friends who were near me to cheer me? Believe me, they knew that you were the kind that would hurt me when I needed you. I say, you drive me crazy. What did I do? What did I do to you?
Short but sweet Walter Donaldson number, which he wrote words and music of. We're coming to the end now, actually. I think we only have two more numbers. This is we are penultimate number, so I better select something, chaps.
What would you like?
Well, hang on. Oh, I double dare you, Squire. If you want something up-tempo, medium, slow, waltz. You want a waltz? Okay. You don't want a waltz? How many? Okay, I'll have to hear from volume. How many want a waltz? Okay, how many want a really up-tempo foxtrot? Oh, Lord, I'm stuck. Okay.
Say it isn't so.
Well, I don't know what to do. Okay.
Say it isn't so.
Which one?
Say it isn't
okay.
So.
Okay. Well, we'll cross. Well, no. Well, next time we'll do a tango. Let's do Say It Isn't So. An up-tempo. We'll do a nice medium fast Irving Berlin number, and then we'll do our final number. Okay, so Say It Isn't So. Say It Isn't So. Okay.
Okay.
How do you want to start it? Richard started. Okay. One, a two, a one, two, three, four. He's playing a melody.
Say it isn't so. Everyone is saying you don't love me. Say it isn't so. Everywhere I go, everyone I know whispers that you're growing tired of me. Say it isn't so. People say that you found somebody new, and it won't be long before you leave me. Say it isn't true. Say that everything is still okay. That's all I want to know. And what they're saying, say it isn't so.
Richard. David knew, found somebody new. And it won't be long before you leave me, say it isn't true. Say that everything is still okay, that's all I want to know. And what they're saying, say it isn't so. Well, I do believe we've reached the last number. We're going to do one more. This is our goodnight song. It's been wonderful playing for you tonight. And we have, of course, Don Neely has been singing and playing with us from San Francisco. And Jeff Newdell on the reeds, a fine reed section here. On the piano, Mr. Richard Gere. And on the bass, Mr. Tim Emmons. Mr. Fred Sokolow on the electric guitar. And Daniel Glass on the drums. And my name is Ian Whitcomb. And we will return. We will return. Yes. Now let's go to the back of the book and let's select something. I'll see you in my dreams. I don't know. Shall we do that? A thousand good nights. Good nights. A thousand good nights. Pull out a thousand good nights. This is another Walter Donaldson song called A Thousand Good Nights. It is a lovely, lovely song. All right. What fell over? All right. Anyway. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. A one. You ready?
Yes.
A little introduction, perhaps? A one, a two, a one, two, three. Have waited till moonbeams have faded and gone. Good night, a thousand good nights. I'll miss that love light that lasted from twilight till dawn. That one little moment meant hours of bliss, forgetting what no meant. And sighing like this. Good night. Tonight was like heaven. Hold me and kiss me and wish me a thousand good nights. Well, again, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. This is Ian Whitcomb and his Bungalow Boys. Don't forget us, we'll never forget you. And we'll be around this year, next year, and forever. That wonderful moment meant hours of bliss, forgetting what no meant, meant sighing like this. Good night, tonight was like heaven. Hold me and kiss me and tell me a thousand good nights. Good night, everybody. Good night.
gentlemen, you've been listening to Ian Whitcomb and his Bungalow Boys here at the Cicada Club. And ladies and gentlemen, a night at the Cicada Club is brought to you by the Dumont Television Network, where each and every Sunday we bring you the finest in entertainment for your viewing pleasure by means of electronic television. So for now, ladies and gentlemen, this is Maxwell DeMille wishing you all the best of good luck and good evening. The wherewithal to come to San Francisco.